All right, we got a lot of stuff coming out of this AEW show. Hangman's team lost, so Hangman will not be challenging Kenny Omega. We have the announcement of the United Center in Chicago for an episode of Rampage. Hiroshi Tanahashi was on the show. Chris Jericho did a match with light tubes. Where do you want to start?
Chicago is probably where to start. That's the big story. It's pretty obvious watching that the Rampage show on August 20th is going to be probably, I mean, one would think the debut of CM Punk. I mean, there's no other reason to book Chicago for another show. Certainly not book the United Center. And I think that is a huge risk. It's an expensive building. If it was the pay-per-view and, which actually, you know, if it was the pay-per-view and for whatever reason, and you can't really logistically do this, but if it was the pay-per-view on the 5th of September and they made it clear that CM Punk was going to be on that show and they moved that show to the United Center, they'd have to sell, you know, 5,000-6,000 more tickets. And I think they would instantly on September the 5th. If it was on September the 3rd or the 1st, I think they would sell out the Now Center. I don't know, or Now Arena. I don't know that they would sell at the United Center. They might, but I don't know that. For August 20th, it's in a market that you've already got tickets for three shows on sale. If he sells that out or comes close, that is an incredible achievement to do that. It's a 3-week build. They have not announced Punk. To sell that out, they're going to have to either announce Punk publicly, and I think they're going to have to, or strongly suggested he was on and everybody chanted, so I'm pretty sure that's it, but it'll be a real test. Chicago is the city you have to do it in, and
before you go any further, I mean, if you guys did not see the show, I mean, they announced the United Center. The fans are loudly chanting for CM Punk. They're getting close-ups of fans chanting for CM Punk. And then go to Darby Allin, who talks about how he's going to be there in Chicago and he wants to face the best in the world. So I think that between now and Rampage, they're probably going to do everything in their power to tell you that CM Punk is going to be in the show without actually telling you. So it's still kind of a surprise. But I mean,
then
how
are they going to sell 15,000 tickets with maybe? You got to have that.
They told you tonight. I mean, that's the way it came off on television.
We'll find out. Tickets go on sale Friday, so.
They had 6,000 people in the building that all knew tonight.
Yeah, but is that?
And you know, the other thing you do is you put tickets on sale, and if they're not going well, if all else fails, then
true.
You announce he's going to be there. So what difference does it make?
That's true. When tickets go on sale, they're going on sale Friday for pre-sale and then Monday to the general public. And on Monday, yeah, you can kind of gauge it from there. If they have 12,000 tickets sold because everyone thinks it's CM Punk, then they can just have the surprise. If they have 3,000 tickets sold, then they better announce them right away. That's because there's not a lot of time to build this thing. And they have to draw from the local market because the people who were going to come in for something special are coming in Labor Day weekend. There are people who would have come in Labor Day weekend, but they couldn't get tickets to the Sunday show. So maybe some of those people would come in 2 weeks earlier just because, you know, they want to see Punk's first match. They may get, it is a Friday, which is a better day to draw than a Wednesday as far as the live gate. The big thing on this, though, is, and I guess, you know, it's the second episode of Rampage. They really want to establish that time slot. At the same time, the debut of CM Punk, if it was on, you know, like, again, I would debut CM Punk on Dynamite, not on the pay-per-view. I would you know, push something big for him at the pay-per-view, but I would debut him on Dynamite because I believe that they would.
Sure, seems like Darby Allin
on the pay-per-view. Well, that's good. And CM Punk's wanted to wrestle Darby Allin, so that makes all the sense in the world. And Darby Allin cut that promo. They're going to do that match. I don't think there's any doubt about that. That's probably Punk's first match. I don't know if it's going to be that pay-per-view or, but probably is the best place to be would be that pay-per-view in Chicago. which is crazy. You know, one of the things that's happened this week, which is amazing, is the secondary market business, and this is before tonight, this actually started about 5 days ago, the secondary market business for the September 5th show is now the strongest in the history of pro wrestling. There's two reasons for this. I mean, as far as price, the get-in price, the last I checked, which was a couple hours ago, was $323, which is the all-time record for pro wrestling by a lot. There have been shows in the 150 range. I remember the Nakamura show when he debuted in Dallas was 155. I believe that there were two shows that hit 200. I think one was a Royal Rumble and one was I think it was the All Out show. The first All In show, I think, was the real big one. So what happened here, it's actually an amazing story, is because, you know, the people who were ticket brokers did not listen to our show the night before when we said it's probably going to sell out tomorrow the first day, and it did. They did not jump on that one like they would had they known, and there were only 785 tickets sold to the secondary market. And then a lot of those started selling pretty quick, because and at very high prices at first. So what's happened in the last week was a lot of secondary market people bought the existing secondary market tickets, as did fans that wanted to get in thinking that CM Punk's going to be appearing on the show. So what they did was they would buy the tickets at, let's say you buy a ticket at 200 and then you put it up for 400 thinking you're going to get that profit. And that's kind of what happened to a lot of the tickets, and then the tickets moved too. So people that did that did not fail, and that's why it's $323 to get in, and most tickets are way above that. If you want, that's for the worst tickets. For the best tickets, I don't know what it is. It's thousands of dollars though. I haven't looked at the top end yet. I'll probably do that tomorrow. But it is because of the scarcity of tickets, and the fact that it's hot. Yes, this is by far, it's not even close, this is the highest priced secondary market pro wrestling ticket of all time. So a lot of people are going to be very upset hearing that too, because number one, they don't realize it's a scarcity of ticket. They thought that all the scalpers bought that show. In fact, the scalpers didn't buy that show. They did buy the Arthur Ashe show, because as always happens in these cases, when the secondary market brokers get shut out, realize they're shut out, they buy the next show, the next big one, and that's the next big one. So there were like 2,000 tickets sold to the secondary market of the Arthur Ashe show, which is, you know, a decent amount. So anyway, he's got to be on the show, and you know, that's pretty much it, and we'll see what happens. I guess it worked out that way. I don't know. I would have waited the 2 weeks and put him on Dynamite on the Wednesday and gone for the record rating of Dynamite, because I think that it may not have beaten the first show, but I think it would have the chance to beat the first show. I mean, there's no Olympics. There's, you know, nothing big in competition on September the 1st as compared to, you know, there's going to be no NFL against on Wednesday nights. And they're hot. I mean, they're the hottest they've ever been. So, you know, on Friday night at 10 o'clock, that's a lot. As we've seen, that's a lot tougher. They probably will do a hell of a rating for the show. I mean, by whatever they're going to do on Friday nights, it'll probably be a hell of a number. But it won't be nearly the number that Dynamite would have done, you know, for Wednesday. So, but I'm sure he's got the reason, and, you know, August 20th. If he's wrestling, I would expect the record pay-per-view number for the company too on September 5th if he's wrestling on the show.
Hey, if you're a big fan of Wrestling Observer Radio, we got 12,000 episodes of all of our podcasts up at our website, wrestlingobserver.com. If you sign up today, you get access to every single one of them. The 12 to 18 new shows that we do every single week. You can podcast them, listen to them on the road, at work, working out, in the shower, wherever you listen to your podcasts, and also full access to the Wrestling Observer newsletter and archives. So if you love what you hear, head to WrestlingObserver.com. 12,000 audio shows at your fingertips.